Those who came grab it with both hands. Yes? I don't know. Maybe I'm speaking to the wrong person. It's a place where you make long-lasting friends. And in some cases, you even meet your life companion. My son went to Dalhousie University. He met a young lady at the Mount. He's married and living in Bermuda with three children. So university does have some excitement. It does have some love. So if you ask me what I would do differently at university, if I had the opportunity to go back and to look at myself 20 or 30 years younger, I'm not only 10 in my 30s, what I would say is that I would get involved in the activities. I would participate in more. Project management skills, leadership, presentation skills, very powerful. If you are not in a group, maybe that's one of the groups you might want to join. I'm also aware that SMU is a multicultural and global connected university. There are many, many people that I have met here in Nova Scotia since I came here in 2004 who have come to SMU and have gone back to their country of origin and have done incredible things. Such strength this university has can only serve to build cultural intelligence, diversity, and inclusion. Students who understand and value difference. You have the opportunity to break down the silos and help to build a mosaic of Canada. And not only Canada, but Nova Scotia. And this global community that St. Mary's have, you have the opportunity, those who are international students, to become ambassadors for Canada. International students also play a critical role in exporting Canada to the world. Because you come here, you learn, and you take that, and you build communities, and you build lives, and you create a country equally as creative. There is also a call for gender equality on boards, and I'm so delighted to see two young women taking up the challenge to participate, because we need more women on boards. So focused on the negative that they understanding. Your candidates here will need your help once elected. So find a place, find something that you can do to broaden your horizon, build your confidence, and help you to get to where you want to get. So in conclusion, as I said, get involved, build your knowledge base, ask for what you need by your community or group sale or the university. Use your knowledge and convert it into action. Take a break, breathe, have fun also. Meet other students outside of your own culture. Network. Join groups that will move you further beyond your own cultural groups and take you into opportunities. Take advantage of the opportunities that you have. And lastly, be comfortable with that uncomfortable feeling of learning something new. And as you vote, or when you consider to vote, step outside of yourself and see how far it will take you. Thank you.
Speech. I'm sure you touched a lot of people in attendance this evening, so let's give her another round of applause. So as of right now, we're going to move on to the referendum portion of this evening, and as well, we have the opportunity to have another great speaker to help us out with this portion of the event. Ms. Paula Minnikin is in attendance with us. Paula has been SMUSA's governance consultant for several years, as she sits on the board of directors for numerous organizations, including the NSLC and the board of governors for NASCAP. Paula also has her own consulting firm, which focuses on executive leadership and governance, and we are very happy to have her helping us out this evening. So let's give a great round of applause for Ms. Paula.
We have six questions that are going to be under referendum, as I think you all know, and we're And it's one of those things that makes me feel very confident about my future outside graduation.
I also got the opportunity to attend a national conference that is held by Canadian University Press. So there's a Canadian Press, then there's a Canadian University Press, and it's the only student-run national cooperative for student press in all of North America. And by the entire student population, we get to love that and meet other journalists and other press professionals.
Why don't you write this new journal? Because you can. We publish everything that's been written and sent to us. It's real-world experience. It's a fully functioning society with a board, and you get those skills that employers look for afterwards.
We will almost certainly publish it, and because five can't see it, because it matters.
So many graduates have been
So this is fairly straightforward. A few things first, just given that Paul has been allowed to mention I'm on the board, I'll just take it. I only need 30 seconds, so take 2.5 minutes versus just talk about what our year. Thank you, Greg. So first, thank you everybody for coming tonight. It's really important to us as a board and as an organization to promote student engagement. And that's something we've talked about a lot this year. And that's sort of where this referendum is coming from. At the start of this year, we looked as a board at what are the strategic priorities of our student association. And we've been focusing on several things, initiatives of executive and initiatives of our board. Some of these things in particular, as has been referenced by Rachel, the mental health, that's something that we're focusing on at the university level, and also through our lobbying organization, Student Administration, and also the Canadian Alliance of Student Associations. But another thing we've really been trying to focus on this year is how can we be a student association that represents all students? How can we be inclusive, and how can we provide the support to marginalized groups? And that's something that's really been sort of talked about across the country as student associations in our respective lobbying organizations, but also the discourse that's happened right here at St. Mary's. And particularly important, given our high population of international students and different marginalized groups and just the history of marginalized groups in Nova Scotia. And that's something you've certainly had in our comments about just female engagement in student government and engaging our international population and looking at Aboriginal students, which is a priority through CASA. So something that came forward, not from myself, but from our board members and our governance committee, is the question that SMUSA believes in equality and inclusion of all students. Do you support amending the Constitution to include only gender-neutral language? So this is what I'm getting at, is how can we be a more inclusive and a more student-centered university and student-centered student association? And that really starts with just the language we have at the board level. We believe we have a role to play in setting the tone for our organization, but we can't change the Constitution without you, our students. So I think I have the very good pleasure of presenting the only referendum that doesn't require you to pay any money this year. but it is to our Constitution, and as a board, something to remember is we ultimately report to you, the students. You elect us, and we are accountable to you. So essentially, we need 2/3 of you to vote in favor of changing this. This will help us with our other initiatives around inclusivity, around providing support for marginalized groups, and really setting that gender tone and writing that to try and be inclusive of both men and women and our transgendered students or students who identify as otherwise. So that's the impetus for this question, a long-winded way of telling you a sentence-long question. But again, SMUSA believes in equality and inclusion of all students. Do you support amending the Constitution to include only gender neutral language? I'm over 3 minutes, but I hope you will. Thank you.
Several student-run projects. These projects range from providing support to refugees, working with women in prisons, and arranging the distribution of feminine hygiene products to women in Kenya. Enact to St. Mary's is open to all students across the campus. Do you support Enact to St. Mary's in receiving an annual levy of $2, simply one cup of coffee a year, to sustain the growth of these projects?
To really harp on the it's open to all students across campus, I brought this up here to not misquote, but Miss Anne Devine said she couldn't step outside of herself. And she encouraged us to get involved, participate more in something new and in something different. That's what an activist can provide for essentially. It's not limited to business students. Currently this year, year, one of our residents is a triple major within commerce, and the other one is an environmental science major. It's not just limited to commerce students. That's something that a lot of people don't realize. We have a lot of people through several different projects, as Leslie mentioned. One of those specifically is Options Nova, which goes into a women's prison. There they work with the women and help them gain employability skills, so that when they come back into the workforce, they're less likely to go back to prison. These are key important things, gaining confidence, building their skills, building their ability to improve the community more.
So we kind of touched on the Kenya project a little bit in the question, but to give you a little bit more information on it, it's through our Options International project. So on Saturday, myself and two other colleagues are going down to Assembly Kenya, and we are going in with Days for Girls and Chalice. And our goal is to teach women in these communities how to make their own feminine hygiene products. Now, it's estimated that 1 in 10 African women end up missing more than a week of school a month, leading them to fall behind in their studies and eventually dropping out of school. This isn't fair whatsoever. We believe that this education should be available for anybody. So with these feminine hygiene products, we're going to teach the women how to make them, as well as teach them how to start up their own enterprise so that they can actually end up selling them to more women in the communities.
And on the notion of startups, we also work with several startups. We have a program called the Startup 100. Helps entrepreneurs start businesses across the country. We really do have everything, something for everyone, and we really want to make that apparent to all of you. We have networking opportunities through our events, chances to meet executives, great opportunities to learn more about presentation skills, find out how to do well in the interview. We have this available for all of you, and it's truly making a difference in the over 200 members that we have currently. The $2 does make a massive, massive difference. It's very little to each of you, but in the end, for us, it could allow us to not waste time fundraising and help other people change their lives.
Questions. coming. So I think I'm going to take Anne's advice and update my wardrobe with the 3D printer. So I'm going to have to, if you don't mind, I'll borrow that. Sounds like a more cost-effective approach to what I'm doing. So what unites all of us today? What is one thing that we have in common? We're St. Mary's University students, and we care about the future of our university. My name is Collette Robert, and I'm a Bachelor of Science, Honors in Psychology, Biology minor, graduate of St. Mary's University. And now I'm currently pursuing my Master's of Applied Science, more specifically in Neuroscience. Anyways, my love for St. Mary's University's Student Association began 5 years ago, so that dates me a little bit, when I decided to become a welcoming leader. So since then, I've had several different roles within SMUSA, including a department manager, society creator, and co-president of the Medical Society, which I stepped down from, and now currently as Vice President University Affairs within SMUSA. So I advocate for student interests on campus. So that includes on a campus level, provincial with Students NS, and federal with the Canadian Alliance of Student Associations, CASA. So I understand both the operations and the governance perspectives of SMUSA. Attending previous SMUSA Board of Directors meetings, learning policies, building relationships, all of these things are part of what has contributed to gaining an understanding of our organization. I have a vision for St. Mary's University to be a leader in several different initiatives and be the best university in Canada. My presidential platform includes several key areas that matter to me and, most importantly, our students. The first pillar of my platform includes student assistance. So as Anne had mentioned, many people nowadays take on student loans and have difficulty paying them back. And for a certain proportion of students, this leads them to declaring bankruptcy. I have been advocating and will continue to advocate on your behalf. I'm committed to ensuring that money collected from the university's recently announced tuition increases is allocated back into student bursaries to enhance student services. If elected, I will work with the university administrators to ensure that students receive adequate student assistance during their degree, limiting the financial burden facing most students as they complete their post-secondary education. The second pillar of my platform is mental health. I have been actively working with several students and administrators on campus to begin developing a feasible plan to better deliver health-related services and programming on campus. So as previously mentioned, we recently created a referendum question for the CSO election with the intent of raising funds to further implement a strategic plan for improving mental health. If elected as president, I am committed to building on these initial steps forward and so SMUSA can become a national leader in student mental well-being. The third pillar of my presidential platform is equity groups. So you might be thinking to yourself, what are equity groups? Well, that's any group on campus that's considered to be a minority, or less than 50% of the population. So these include, but are not limited to, international students, LGBT, and Aboriginal students. I support you, and as a team, I believe we can make a difference on campus by providing equity groups with increased financial and resource supports to build a fair, more inclusive, and balanced university community. Yes, we may be from different backgrounds, have different upbringings, but we are all St. Mary's University students, and when we unite, we can bring strength to the table. We are one people, one university, one world, ours.
Taking the time of your busy schedules, and for some of you in the middle of midterms studying, to be here tonight. So my name is Shawn Nicholson. I'm a fourth-year commerce student majoring in computing and information. information systems, and I'm here running to become your next MUSA president for 2016-2017. The reason I'm running is simple. I have the necessary experience, attitude, and work ethic to best serve, advocate, and represent you as president of SMUSA. In 2014, I was elected to the SMUSA Board of Directors, and I'm serving the last year of my term presently. I currently serve you as Vice Chair of the Board and Chair of the SMUSA Governance Committee. I also represent you currently as a student governor on the university's Board of Governors and a student representative on the Bachelor of Commerce Council. If elected, I'll be a strong advocate for your interests. My platform consists of four pillars: health and wellness, community, communication, and transparency. Health and wellness are paramount to student success here on campus and to a positive student experience. As president, I will ensure that SMUSA helps support students and partners with the university to help deliver services to promote and maintain student health, including mental health. Additionally, I see that the SMUSA Wellness Committee is fully functioning and meeting regularly. Before the campaign, I had the opportunity to speak with many students who feel that there's not enough connection between Canadian and international students here on campus. I believe that SMUSA can continue to play an important role in both holding and the promotion of events on campus that are cross-cultural in nature, such as just one way of building community. I'd also like to see the SMUSA Events Committee be fully functioning and meeting regularly. This committee, along with the Wellness Committee, are both consisting of student representatives from various aspects of student life. As president, I would make sure that they both play an important role in community building. I'm a firm believer that the success of our student association requires clear and constant communication. I found that true in various roles I've held in the past. I'd like to create a comprehensive communication strategy with SMUSA, for SMUSA. This strategy would aim to better inform students of the great services that SMUSA offers and also promote events. The SMUSA app, social media, and other mediums are just key to that strategy. However, more can be done. If elected, I believe communication should be an important focus of the executive and will be if I'm elected as president. Lastly is openness and transparency. If elected, I'll hold quarterly update sessions with students. These sessions would be open sessions with students, similar to the student assembly held last month. However, they would be held regularly. With each session also would come a quarterly report available to students. In addition to those four pillars, I would ensure that students are represented well and your voice is heard, both at the university level, provincially through Students Nova Scotia, and federally through CASA. I believe that I have the experience and ability to put this plan into action. But more importantly, you, as students and members of our great association, are the most important part. If elected, I promise to you that I will seek your continual input and feedback. Let's move forward together. I'm Shawn Nicholson, and I'm asking for your vote on February 24th and 25th, and the privilege to continue to serve you as your next president of the St. Mary's University Student Association.
As possible. If you cannot get anything, you can always ask me questions later. So hi everyone, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh and namaste to everybody. I am Kazi Rahman, a third year international student from Bangladesh studying accounting. Firstly, I would like to congratulate the current team of executives and board for SMUSA for their student-oriented initiatives over the past year. To touch base on my education experience, work experience, I've previously worked with as a leap year mentor to facilitate the transition from high school to university with first year students. I currently work as an RSO at Resident Department and supervisor at Dockside Diving Hall with Aramark Canada Limited. I have a simple ideology: treat people the way you expect to be treated. Over the last 2.5 years, I have tried to connect myself with my fellow peer and take initiative on a personal level to help them in any possible way I could, by advising, mentoring, or spending time with them. I would now like to take the opportunity to present my platform. I was never involved in SMUSA a lot, but these are the things that I've came across my mind while being involved in campus. First, we are students and we are here to study. I would like to initiate to stabilize tuition fees by soliciting minimum rates possible through increased funding for bursaries and scholarship at students' disposal. Secondly, though I never lived in residence, but my year-long involvement with the resident department gave me this opportunity that to increase the move-out time after your last exam from 24 hours to 48 hours. Because I think after a meat grinding week of exams and term paper, you need one day to rest and one day to move out to leave your apartment as it is. So next is initiate more major bank ATMs on campus. We only have RBC. It takes $3 off from your account. So I think we should have a CIBC, Nova Scotia Bank, and all the others, so that we can save those $3. Another burning issue that I've seen on social media nowadays, that was spotted at SMU, is the Wi-Fi access. One of the fellow students said, the fact that the Wi-Fi only, puts up Facebook is that they don't want us to win. I feel bad about it, but this is something we need to work on. Then is empowering students and engaging students more with SMUSA, societies, and faculty. I think these three plays a very key role in just to make sure that they don't drop out, because we are here in university, we are here not to drop out. We'll make it to the end. More jobs on campus, especially for our disabled students, as a part of our social responsibility, because it matters. We need to ensure that they have a job and they also get the experience just like every other of us. Well, we are very fortunate, so thank God for it. Introduce debit and credit cards at Tim's. It's funny, but still I'll try. Let's see how it works. Initiate events and program to educate students and create more social awareness on sexual harassment, consent culture, LGBTQ, mental stability. Create a culture of mutual respect, as we are one big family where every member has a different ideology, and learn to respect each other. Encourage new societies to emerge in order to increase solidarity among students. Cooperate it's something that I've come across, it might sound really stupid, but it's like during exam time or even when you're studying in the library, you're very tired at times. So cooperative massage sofa in library, it's generate revenue and also you can get some relaxation. I would like to end my speech on the note that it's your campus, your voice, your vote, make it count. Do vote, if not for me, your favorite presidential candidate. Thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen.
Just take a minute to tell a story that I didn't originally plan to tell. Last week, unfortunately, I did travel out of the province for a family issue. And part of that was seeing a lot of my family that I don't usually get to see. And one thing I noticed, we're all the same. I mean, you draw a lot of your values from your family. And the thing that I really noticed, everybody would try to give. Like, I got offered food so many times, I thought they were trying to overfeed me. I definitely relate with that a lot as well. I really do like to give in any way that I can. So the four major things that I really want to work on are student voice, mental health, student advocacy, as well as just overall campus life. So some of the things with student health, overall health, really, both mental and physical. Of course, he saw some mental health programs that we can run, some services that we can run as well, would be great. But also physical. You know, we do have the student plan, of course, but if we can improve in any way, I would really like to look at that and see if there's anything that I can improve upon. So student voice as well. I've experienced some of the issues that students face, of course, but there are things that I can't speak to that other students can. You know, everyone has their own experiences, everyone runs into their own issues. So I would hope to open up that forum and have students be able to speak to the student association, and so that we can hear your voice, know what the problems are, and try to work on them. Student advocacy is also a very important one. We definitely have those already in some capacity with students from Scotia, as well as the Canadian Alliance of Students Association. I myself actually sit on the board for students from Scotia as it is. Definitely moving on with those. I'd also like to hear from students as well for that. Hosting a forum where students are able to present some of the problems that they would like brought forward to government, which I would then take from there and once meeting with government, speak on some of those. Another thing is overall campus wellness. This is the life for a lot of people. A lot of people live on residence. Making residence life maybe a little better. Maybe some stuff with some of the food options. Perhaps having a convenience store on campus. Other things like that as well. Some of the other things that I'd also like to kind of work on are employment opportunities, perhaps having communication with potential employers, and even possibly having something such as a job fair. Again, I'd like to thank you all for coming out here. It really is important for students to get involved. If you see me on campus at any point in time, feel free to stop me, ask me a question. I would be more than happy to help. You can also contact me by my email, kbox.org@gmail.com. That's on my posters around campus. Thank you very much.
Thank you for coming out here today. It's important. On a note of aside, my school kind of life, I have been involved politically on a very unique scale. I had the opportunity to work at the Nova Scotia Legislature for the last few years and sit in a nonpartisan role and see how it all works, see how bills are made, see how committees are run, to go through a budget line by line, a pretty big budget, to be fair. I've also worked in the PEI legislature, seeing the same thing, writing speeches for politicians, understanding what it's like to be on that side of the board. And the last thing, the most important thing to me, is that I am human, and I really want that to be important whenever you guys, if I gain office, I want you to be able to come talk to me. I am just obsessed with Beyonce's Super Bowl performance, if you guys know. It was amazing. And I'm not gonna lie, at 3 o'clock this morning, I was laying in bed playing Candy Crush. It was really good. So,
I won't be telling a speech today, I'll be telling a small story about Ossama and his brother, SMUSA.
Who's Ossama?
So, Ossama ran for president in his first year when he didn't know anything about SMUSA. He saw his friends running for board and they were like, Ossama, do you want to run? I was like, yeah, I'm running for board. They were like, oh, well, if you are running, okay, I run for president. I ran at that time for president. I was standing in the debate, the only question I asked myself in the debate, what are you doing here, Sam? I was sitting next to Amali, next to Preston, Amali would be like, are you nervous? I'd be like, no. And if you ask me, are you nervous? From 10, I was 15. After that, I read out from the election in round one, 7 votes away from the second place. I was so proud of myself. I believe running in my first year doesn't count, but what really counts is the experience I gained. I didn't give up on SMUSA. I applied right away after it to be a VP events and programming. And I knew I won't get it at that time because I didn't have that much of experience. I got a call that I didn't get it. I stayed with SMUSA. I applied for a back leader. I traveled in summer, came back early just to be a back leader. I met great people in like a new family. Being a back leader in orientation week, I tried my best to stay with SMUSA at that time. After that, I ran a campaign called Get Out to Vote. For the federal elections, my friend used to make fun of me. He'd be like, oh, Sam, you're not even allowed to vote. Why are you campaigning for me? And I used to say, I'm not allowed to vote, but trust me, I can make people vote. After that, 2 weeks later, I found a job that they need a vice president to the first, and that time I was like, Osama, it's your time. Let's do this. Osama came for release during the first, and he got it. And for that time, he was in charge of more than 50 societies on campus and trying his best to find volunteer opportunities for students. Osama's setting committees, which is Dean's Review Committee, First Year Experience Committee, making sure that first year students get the experience and get involved. Osama sits in the Sponsors Committee with the university. If you ask me what's my platform, I'll be like, one thing, fighting for students. It's time to fight for students who live in residence and not give them a day or two or three after their finals. It's time to give them the full 2 weeks for free because they're already paying for the whole 8 months. We already paid for the 8 months. Why aren't you letting us go out that early? Can you leave? It doesn't make sense. You're allowed to leave your stuff in residence, but you're not allowed to stay. Why? It's time to be like, Tim's, we need a debit. It's time to stand and tell them we need a debit, not just talk about it. If it's costing us $6 to get a coffee, do you know that? Yes, if you're not with RBC, you go withdraw, it costs you $3. Your bank charges you $1.50, this is $4.50, and you get your coffee for $2. That's $6.50 to get a coffee. Why? Because Tim's doesn't want to get a debit machine, it costs him $2.25 each transaction. It's time to raise our voice. For both, it's time to be with students in classes. When a prof asks you to get a book or a code for your course. And you know, you don't need that code. You have already the book, but it helps the prof. I don't know, neutral in a commission in a way. It's time to tell them that you don't need this and you can learn without this platform. For example, when you go in class and the prof expects you to buy books for $300, and at the end of the day, you get the midterm and the final from the slides. The question is, why we should do this? Okay, thank you so much. Well, thank you. Well, I think certainly the big issue that I want to look at is creating a strategic plan that is from day one established. Just last week, so a part of that strategic plan additionally is also, you know, looking at what is SMUSA. And a lot of students, you know, certainly not you guys here, you're here tonight and you're engaged and, you know, hats off to you, thank you. A lot of students may not know and don't know what SMUSA is all about. They think it might be a department of the university, but SMUSA is not. SMUSA is independent. SMUSA is actually their active incorporation. Our active incorporation is older than the universities. We've been established since 1966, so I think it's important that we have a strategic plan that looks at what our organization is all about. Just last week, there was a post on Spotted at SMU, and I'm going to paraphrase this. The post said, SMUSA, looking after its corporate employees since 1966, not students. That caught me off guard. If students believe that SMUSA is looking out for its corporate employees, I think there's a problem that has to be looked at. So that would be my first, you know, action.
That was one inspiring story by Ossama. The first thing is, I try not to promise anything that I cannot do. If I can go for a day extra, I'll go for a day extra, rather than make a promise that's very unrealistic for the whole semester. As I've mentioned it before, again, it's the first thing that I know that I'll be doing is implement the relationship that I have with the resident department is, again, to increase that one day. It's not only, I don't want to promise anything. This is what I think I'll be able to do very fast and efficiently. So that's why that's the only one thing that that will be my first thing if I'm elected as the president. Thank you so much.
You know, I definitely hear a lot of good points here today. I'm glad to be running against this group of people. It's a very strong group of people overall. But to get to the question anyway, the first issue that I would try to tackle is student voice in general. That covers a little more than just student voice with the association. That's student voice with government. government, you know, they brought in the loans. It was said earlier today that there was a time when there wasn't any loans; it was all grants. And now we get out of a school with so much debt, it's ridiculous. I took 2 years at NSCC myself, and I'm still leaving school with $20,000 in debt, at least, if not more. We definitely need to work on that, but we need to be heard. There are other issues as well that I believe, with the voice of the entire student body, could definitely be tackled. I think we have the power to make a real change. Thank you.
By solving this issue, we'll be able to know what students are facing, and we will be able to tell students that we are not just an organization that provides services, but we are the voice of the students. By solving the gap, we'll be able to make students, whenever they have an issue, comes to us before going to anyone and tells us we have this going on. This will make us really, really ahead, like, to be able to solve their issues. And I couldn't complete. My last issue is university security. When the university security tells me in the atrium that I'm not allowed to stay because I forgot my ID at home, or I'm not allowed to eat because of the atrium policy, I'll be like, I respect you, sir, and appreciate the work you're doing for me, but let me tell you my policy. My policy is I'm a Canadian student who works 6 hours a day in order to be able to pay for my tuition. Or, you know what, an international student who came all the way from the Middle East to be able to study and get an opportunity, and you are telling me you're out of the line because I forgot my ID? Don't they have an A number? So this issue is, you know what's funny about our university? Our students are the best students. When you ask students, what's your issue? It's not financial aid, not increase 3% every year. Our biggest issue in CMU is having a microwave in the atrium. This is our biggest student aspiration. That's so funny, it's a microwave. So, we need to work hard to get that in the game.
Thank you.
Thank you.
By doing my part and helping you with the things that you would like to see change. So I have a vision for St. Mary's University to be a leader in several different initiatives and be the best university in Canada. So to expand on these points, I would aim to have my team be gender balanced. So I would like all of my VPs to be completely equal. Our team should reflect our campus, which is very diverse in nature. So also, I would aim to hire based on competency. I would not hire my friends at the time. Everyone should have a fair opportunity to be involved in SMUSA and make a difference. We're at a time where our environment is constantly changing. The first item I would like to take action on could change depending whether it's tomorrow or the day following that. So once we have a strong team established, I would like to look at reinstating an equity center as well. This could be a students, LGBT and Aboriginal students. Also in terms of consistency, I'm also considering doing my doctorate. So a fundamental issue that we have with our current structure is that someone who is elected in office for 1 year often doesn't have time to implement the things that they want to do. It's just the nature of our structure organization. So if I turn my program into a PhD, I would like to run again to provide you with that consistency. And then in terms of making change on whatever I chose to do, again, I have the provincial and federal experience, and I have pre-existing relationships within the university and within the student population, and I want to meet more of you to know what you guys want to change.
Yes!
Well, there are six candidates running this this election, and everybody's working in their own way. They're working, but their aim is one, that's student welfare, and to work for the students. To be really honest, I don't have any questions for Scott. I think he stands to his platform. I stand to mine just like others stand to theirs. And what I want to is, like, if I'm there, I'll be working on mine, and I'll be working with them as well. So, to be really honest, don't have any questions. Thank you.
Well, I'm definitely not going to do a tag in these hands. I guess you don't even know which name I drew. I drew Erika's name. Of course, she can tell by the fact that I'm looking at her. So, I mean...
has to be a question.
It does have to be a question.
We're not giving that anymore. You guys don't take 2 more minutes. You have to ask her a question. Put
it
on the spot.
I guess the biggest thing that I would really ask is, I would just ask you to elaborate on some of the steps that you would take to actually follow through with what you plan to do.
Just in general?
Just overall in general. You know, obviously you thought about what you're going to do, what that first issue is you're going to tackle. So I would imagine...
exact thing is? Because I know it's $2 for students. Is there more elaborate if you could explain what those implications would exactly be?
Okay, very good question, Erica. So some of you may know if you're submitting a referendum question through the board, you actually need a breakdown of a budget. So I have put a lot of thought into this. So $2 annually brings you up to approximately $14,000 per year. So what can you do with that money? We had peer mentor specialists implemented on campus. We have two of them. So I think that using a peer mentor is more of a preventative approach for mental health. So rather than you getting to the point where you're having very, very negative thoughts and you have to go through the counseling center and you have a 3 to 4 week wait period, why not sit down with a peer and discuss your issues? With that being said, that costs money to have them here. It's actually $5,000 per person to be exact. That's a contract for a year. So I would look at hopefully implementing two of them per year if we can get that done. I have met with Sarah Morris in the counseling center. I have met with one of the current peer mentor specialists. Alongside with that, if anyone has ever heard of the Elephant in the Room campaign, essentially what that is planting elephants all across campus with professors, faculty, administration that have been trained to speak with people about mental health, just checking in and seeing if they're okay, and then from there you can refer them to other services. Sarah Morris in the counseling center has agreed to partner with us with their mental health 101 training and use that training that's already implemented on campus to vet people through that so they can have an elephant, whether it be in their classroom, in their office. So running that campaign costs money for the elephants, the posters, all that stuff. So that's one campaign that we'll go towards. And I budgeted approximately $2,000 for that. So that brings us to about $12,000 plus taxes, and you want a little leeway. So that is the exact breakdown right now. And potentially guest speakers, which could bring it up to $1,000.
James and now Amali is trying his best to get this relation back. So we work as one hand, we and the university together. And even though us as executive sittings in committees with the university, we're trying our best to build a relation for the next people who's gonna come, the president, the executive, for the board. So I believe right now we are getting a really, really good relation with the university. Chance right now to change something in SMUSA, what would you change?
Well, thank you, Ossama. That's a great question. I'm just going to take a moment here just to think about that. And
That's a really good question.
Well, one thing I think I've changed, first of all, is as president, I think it'd be really important to work with the board and constantly report to the board about the activities. I think that's really important to establish formal presidential reporting. That's something that currently our board policy doesn't have firmly, but as president, I'm going to submit a formal report to the board for their approval at every board meeting. So that would be my first thing that I could change, and I could change it right now. My question for you is, what do you see the role of the president in terms of the relationship with the SMUSA board of directors? What is the president's role, in your view, in your understanding of the responsibilities?
Thank you, Shawn, for your question. I haven't had the privilege to be involved with SMUSA as much as you did, Ossama, Collette. But to my understanding and to my knowledge of the policy is the relationship of the president with the board is that the board is there to monitor the president on the steps that he takes. And because if I personally make a decision, it will be mine. But the 9 board of directors, they project the voice of the students. Because they're not, the more the minds, the more accurate, or I would say precise, or more well-formed decision they can come up with. So I think, yeah, monitoring the president, ensuring that whatever he's doing is the best interest of the student, he's not doing for his own personal interest, and making him accountable for anything they feel like he needs to be accountable of. So I won't go into the technical jargons, I'm not too sure about it, but on a very plain and simple language, I think just monitoring the president's day-to-day operations. Thank you.
Okay, so it's a democracy. And we do have some other questions here that we have ready, which we were going to go to first, but I think it's really important, given that it's 8:45, and we have a lot of people here. And I have to say, I've been doing this a long time. This is a lot of people. You guys should put yourselves in there. It's a full room. So, rather than me do these questions and pass it around, I'm going to give you guys a chance to stand up and give me a sign, and I'll... And either you can say it to me and I'll repeat it to the room, or I'll give you the mic. And you can pose a question to a particular candidate, but I will give everyone the chance to answer it, and they will only get 30 seconds, okay? So does that make sense? So does anyone have a question? All right, guy in the nin hat.
My question is for Ossama, if that's okay?
Yeah.
Yeah. All of your issues are like huge scope, dealing with the residence department 2 weeks. What I assumed was dealing with the teachers and getting them not to buy books, the students not to buy books, removing debit fees, getting TIMS. Other presidents have all tried these things and haven't really had any success. With a year term, how are you going to accomplish all these goals?
Ryan, thank you. I believe everyone who tried to change this, he tried it with policy. He didn't try it with students. He tried it with policy, which is already written. And whenever they say, look at the policy, they'll be like, okay, that's it. We can't talk about it. They haven't tried with students. They haven't got all the students to raise their voice and be like, we need to change this. They haven't done a question or a voting way to make the university know that there's this amount of students who needs to change this. They have met with the university, discussed it, they didn't reach a way, they stepped back. But if you want to change stuff like this, you need to get students and show them that the student's voice does matter and there's a student power. Thank you.
Okay, so I gave him 45 seconds. Would anyone else like to answer it? And you will also give 45 seconds. Anyone else want to answer that question about, so I'll make it more generic, just towards him. Given the things in your platform, if they seem like a lot, how do you accomplish them? If you, because a number of you, I actually wrote down what all your platforms were. You have some very similar things, equity groups, student mental health, health and wellness, $3 fee at the bank machine was in three of you. Residents moving out was with two of you. So does anyone else want to address that question? We're going to let that go. Okay.
Yeah, we got the time. Absolutely. Thank you for your questions. I know it was directed towards Ossama, but as I've see, the thing is, 1 year is not enough for a lot of things that we want to work for any of us standing here. Is I can't claim that we'll do all this thing within that 1 year. It's made impossible. What I think is this association is a relay race. It's like the ancestor passed it on to the to us, and we pass it on to our the person to come next. So it doesn't end here. If a policy, if I take the initiative, if Ossama said he can make it all week, it doesn't end at Ossama. It goes next year as well, it goes next year as well, it goes next year as well, until we implement the policy. We can try, that's how it is. And as I've said, I try to stay at a place, I'm done. Sorry, I'm done. No.
For your question. I don't know. They would have to apply, but essentially what I would like to have is a gender balanced team. So, you know, say 50-50 of people that identify as male or female or maybe something else. And also, I would like it to be very diverse. So in everyone that applies, I would like to see what their background is, hopefully have them incorporate that into their interview, their application. And again, hire based on competency, not who my best friend is.
Would any other candidates like to answer how they plan to hire their VPs?
So I believe when it comes to hiring VPs, it's not, it is at the end of the day maybe the president chose, but there is an hiring committee which is made by the general manager, operating manager, maybe the marketing manager and the president, to try their best to choose the best VP, because if we made the decision just for the president, it's just gonna be getting his friends or even his, who thinks like they know a lot about SMUSA, and but they really don't know that much. So that's why the employment committee helps in hiring VPs.
Of course, given the opportunity, I would like to also keep things diverse. And again, like Ossama said, it's not the decision of just the president, it's a board, it's a committee. But in my first interviews, I would honestly just look for the best candidate. I've personally actually given interviews before. I know what they look like, you know, I've sat on both sides of them. I know it's kind of the traits that are needed for certain positions. I know strong leadership is definitely one of those big traits that are definitely needed in the position of this, as well as other things such as communication, for example. But yeah, I would definitely try to keep it as diverse as possible, but also look at the strongest candidates as well.
With the diversity, gender balance, as Collette mentioned, I would and Ossama that there he's not the president is not the only one. There is a board. I would like to get more experience from around the campus, not only someone who's involved with SMUSA and knows SMUSA, but he has to know the campus, the resident department, who worked with on other departments on campus, student ambassador, things like that, just to incorporate more experience and more campus oriented. Thank you so much.
Going.
Facebook. I believe, as I said, there's a miscommunication gap between us, the students. If the students saw us how hard the executive are working in summer to make Welcome Week a really good week for the upcoming students, if they have seen us preparing for an event or for an assembly, or how our VB Academy going with the student to the dean or to the prof to just make sure that she's there for his back, or our VB with the university, or dealing with all these issues, we are working for students at the end of the day.
Thanks for your question, Rich. So within that question, I think that there's something key that we should identify, that is student engagement. Yes, there is a lack of it. Have I personally tried to change this? I have. With the help of the SMUSA team, we organized a student assembly not too long ago. I personally think it was a better turnout than we've seen in quite a while, so that's great. So in doing that, I think that there is miscommunication. So the students don't actively see what we're doing, and everyone is entitled to their opinion, so I won't discredit that, but I think that we can, again, work on communication and more student engagement.
Well, thank you, Mitch, for the question, and I certainly disagree with that comment. But I can understand where students are coming from. I certainly understand that, and I think it comes down to communication and certainly engagement of students. I think it's important that SMUSA and the executive has a lot more ownership linkage. So linking the executive to students, so discussing with students, having focus groups, having student assemblies, having various things where students are involved. It's important for students to have a voice, and if elected as president, I want to see them have that voice in the operations of our association.
Thank you, Mitch, for your question. I won't disagree to it, but it's like if that's a question that it has been raised, I would like to make it more transparent of information that what the executives are doing over their term. And as Shawn said, a feedback session with the president and the executives on in every semester on what they're doing and what's the progress and what's going around with their decisions, that will give students more reliability on the information that are being passed on. So transparency is very much required. Thank you so much. Scott.
So of course, a lot of the things that I would say have already been said. Student engagement is definitely a big one. Hosting more regular forums for people to attend would also be another thing. But as well, I find that interaction one-on-one is definitely an effective way. So I would say that I would also try to implement things such as a suggestion box or even possibly a booth that could be set up somewhere on campus, maybe once a month, try to even possibly more frequent, try to just get that engagement from students, you know, hear what they're thinking.
Okay, who wants to answer that question? one, two, three, four. All right, so given the four that want to answer, the order will be Ossama first, then Collette, Shawn's declining, Shawn's, and then Kazi's in, and then Scott. Okay, so you're going to pass the mic from one to the other. Go for it.
So the first answer is Shawn. For the second answer, I won't say this time miscommunication, but like, I'm the one who deals with societies, and I deal with, let's say, Chinese society, and in a way, I know how Chinese people, and I don't mean anything, like to stay with each other. So, in our way, what we should do, which we have a big society, is called Speak Up, which is get these people from away and make them sit with Canadian people and kind of learn the culture. And yeah, that would be my answer. Like, we tried our best to get all students involved and engaged, but I'm telling you, to be honest, with Chinese people, we are finding it really hard because they are type of students who came all the way together, started studying English together, and they want to stay together. So, thank you.
Thank you. Well, you know, I think that Ossama, you know, really hit it on the nail when it came to Speak Up. I think opportunities such as that are fantastic for students, especially those international students and from China particularly. I think it's also important that SMUSA really works hard with the university to have an inclusive international welcome week, which is very much intertwined with the welcome week. So there is a separate welcome week for international students. However, all students are able to participate in welcome week in general, but you know, promoting that and sort of starting from day one, I think it's very important to see students engaged and frequent communication with students of all nationalities and cross-cultural events here on campus.
Thank you so much for your question. I've seen in the university that they have tried, they are always trying to get students engaged. But what I would like to see from the Chinese students as well, to respond. You know, that's how I would put it. At times, we go up to them, but we don't get the desired response that we are looking for. So you brought the issue. I commend you for that. Go out to them, tell them, hey, be more involved. We're not going to eat them up. I applied for a volunteering conversation partner with the Tesla Center. So we are there. The university is trying, but we need to get some input from their side as well. Thank you so much.
So I'm definitely hearing a lot of things about student engagement and miscommunication. Personally, I quite like one-on-one interactions. I find that they're a lot more effective. So what I would actually propose is possibly creating a program where we could have international students who have already gone through that process to sign up, and then basically they would be able to have one-on-one interactions with someone who's just coming in and be able to kind of show them the ropes, tell them a little bit about what the culture's like, maybe help them out with their English or whatever else they need.
Okay, next question.
So a lot of my interactions with SMUSA have been as the representative of the charitable organization, Shawn, something that I've dealt a lot with. And Shawn is also something that's had a lot of success at SMU, also greatly because of our student union this year. They helped us out astronomically, as did a lot of new leaders. We couldn't have done what we did without you guys. And
there has to be a question. So I think your question, I'm going to try and help you out here, is that you would like to know if any of the candidates would support adding a position to be the charity director or adding that role to an existing position at SMUSA.
Or barring that, some sort of honorarium, just to kind of supplement, simply because it is a little bit unfeasible, given many students that want to do things, take courses in the summer, or take courses at work.
Okay, I think they have the question. And that's a pretty short question. It's you really have 3 points. You can go with, you know, yes, no, or something in between. So it shouldn't take any more than 30 seconds. Who would like to answer it? I just bought your time to think. All right. So the I'll just go through it again. The order this time is Collette, Shawn. You know the order. Who you pass it to? If you are done and you don't want to, just pass it on to someone else. Okay.
30 seconds.
Thank you for your question. This got me thinking back to a few years ago. We actually did have a volunteer coordinator within SMUSA as a VP position. So I think every year the VP positions kind of change a bit, just depending on who the president is and the demand of the environment. I think that we should reinstate a volunteer position or volunteer coordinator position. They would be responsible for not only Shinorama, but November, many other campaigns, sometimes that slips through the cracks, because if you take it on as a VP as a side thing, or someone's doing it as volunteer work, it is not feasible to do while you're trying to balance school work as well.
I certainly do agree with Collette. I think it's important that we, within SMUSA, support campaigns on campus. Shinorama being one great example. As Paula said, Movember, I really can't add more to that, but it's important that we do have a function, whether it be a dedicated person, maybe not necessarily the executive, but a student staff member that's higher up. There's certainly possibilities there, and I would support that if I was elected as president.
Thank you very much for the question. I mean, short answer, yes. I do really, really believe that there should definitely be some sort of compensation for that. Now, with that in mind, you know, I definitely look into the budget, see what there is, try to open up that position, perhaps have an honorarium or something. As well, Students Nova Scotia, for any of the campaigns, well, not any of the campaigns, but some of the campaigns that they run, they actually have a bit of a budget, and they're able to pay an honorarium to their volunteers, so we can do that as well.
For a great response, so thank you.
draw on your experience as VP student affairs to create better opportunities for societies.
Okay, does anyone else want to answer this besides us? Okay, let's go ahead.
I believe that societies on campus, my experience as a VP, as my experience with societies, as I'm part of an active commerce society, so it's kind of, I really learned what the society needs, especially when it comes to funding, for independent funding, for traveling, for conferences. So I believe we should always support societies because they are who are getting students more involved and engaged, and that's what we really need in our university, in our small community, more involvement and more engaged students. Thank you.
I'll make this very quick. So as many of you know, Osama's position is VP Student Affairs. So that doesn't leave Ossama just solely to deal with societies. He has a whole other portfolio that he has to worry about. And I think that's a little unmanageable. So I think moving forward, we should also look at reinstating a position that is just specific to societies. And they can spend more time, although Ossama dedicates late hours to that. But I think that that would benefit societies.
Even though it should be his turn, but it's okay, go ahead.
No, it's not fine, go ahead.
So my question is, what effect does the president have on the increasing of tuition? Would they have an effect or they do not?
I'm going to say yes, no answer, so you're going to get 10 seconds.
Yes, by all means.
I believe that President is not the only one to be able to answer that question. I believe it should be a joint effort with the entire students.
No, we can lobby, but in the end, not really. We can try.
Before negotiation power is more impactful, and actually reinvesting that money from tuition raises and turning it into bursaries, I think that is a more effective approach.
We most certainly do have a voice. We have four members of the association that sit on the Board of Governors, and when a member of the student body who's on the Board of Governors speaks, board members do listen. So there is an effect there, I believe.
With like respect to all the candidates here, this is like not a question to the any particular candidate. This is an issue that I would like to put forward in front of the presidents. Like, I'm an engineering student. I have six courses, and I have classes throughout the day. So my classes usually ends at 6:30, and I take some more time, like at 7:30 or 7. But by that time, when I go to the dockside, I find that the dockside is closed. So I just want to like tell this to the SMUSA members about it. Is there anything that they could do about it just to extend the time that the dockside has for the students? Because it closes at 7:30, and by that time the students usually, most of them cannot have their supper or dinner. So that's just what I wanted to ask the SMUSA president.
Scott first.
course, there are quite a few people who are out before that, but there are quite a few people who are out after that as well. There's also people who have night classes, and you know, maybe they want to get something to eat after their class. I personally had a 3-hour class, two times a week last semester, and I was usually out by about 9 o'clock. So definitely I would try to look into that and see if there's any way of extending those hours to later.
For armor, $2 for 2 hours for each student, not each semester.
So, as Erika mentioned, we are locked into a contract with Airmark. Would it be open to negotiation potentially? We do have a food committee, so I would start off by either myself or whoever else is on the food committee. To really lobby for that. But again, this could increase costs on their end. If we open another hour, maybe we could look at switching the hours. I think that they would be open to looking into that. I don't see why not, but there is a contract.
Yeah, well, Collette, really, like you said, the exact same comment. There is a food committee, and I do believe students. Any student can apply to join the food committee, but there are budgetary constraints, so something that you can certainly sit down at the table with Airmark and with residents to find a solution in that respect.
Being involved with Airmark and one of their supervisors, they're on weekdays they're open till 8 and weekends they're closed at 7:30. If I remember properly, we used to be open till 8:30 previously, but what happened, the number of people we were getting were way too less. So just to keep a balance between cost and benefit, they cut down the time half an hour, and on weekends it used to be till 8, but now they cut down to 7:30. But yeah, that's something that we need to work on, and definitely I'll put my knowledge and relationship with them in order to work on it. Thank you.
Okay, so the question is regarding the atrium. I'm going to make it one because I'm going to let you do two separate ones. The questions are, how do you improve services at the atrium, specifically around two issues, having security while still allowing people to study in a free way but still guarantee their security and health in that they can't get water after hours? So the question is directed at Ossama. So I will let Ossama go first, and then you'll pass it to Paula.
Oh, that's a good question. What usually they used to do in the atrium before the end of the semester, so if you forget your ID, you used to go to the atrium security, McNally security, and get the permission to stay, so you just check your A number. So that was a really good way, but the last week, they start kicking people out at 2 a.m. and they have an exam at 8 a.m. just because they forget their IDs. So this way we can do reports and send them to the security department to talk about it. And for the food thing, I agree with you. As I'm telling you, the whole issue was like, let's have a microwave in the atrium. And that's not possible because of the atrium policy. They are really strict, but we can talk. We can always raise our voice. And we can have more doors open.
First things first, I don't want to compromise security, so I definitely agree with you. I think that if students don't have their IDs, that maybe we could look at alternative ways as proving that you're a student. I don't want to get rid of that altogether unless we have another plan set in place. I think that they would be willing to negotiate on that, but I think the current structure is good. In terms of water, we do have I don't know if you call it a Brita station right next to the bathrooms, but I don't know if it's working right now. It doesn't work at night, so I don't know why it doesn't. Maybe it's a cost effectiveness on their end, but I think that we can look into negotiating that because I don't see why that would be a huge deal for us.
Well, I'm going to be short and sweet. I think we can have conversations. It's really important that we talk with the appropriate stakeholders involved, so whether it be the security, a suggestion that students have had were logging into your banner accounts with your A number and providing a government piece of ID or another piece of ID. I think that's a solution which is not out of the question by any means.
Working with the resident department, we have a database of students living on campus with their picture. So if we can get a database of students with their picture, they don't even need to attach your legal wallet that has your government ID. So you don't have anything on you. You give your A number, we have a picture, you're standing in front of me, I check it, you're good to go. Did you get that? Did you get that? All right, perfect, sorry.
I don't think I really need to say too much more on it. I think everyone's answered pretty well. If we can have that sort of data system that security has, that would definitely be a big plus, but of course we don't want to give up that security altogether. As well with the water, the station's not working, then obviously that shouldn't be too big of a deal to get it working at night.
I kind of disagree with Ossama's point. I think that asking to have one piece of student ID that most people have anyway and are supposed to have on them is not too much to ask, especially when security's staying there 24 hours, always making sure that we're safe. And I really don't think it's that much to ask for you to have your student ID.
Two recent examples that I've observed. Welcome Week, we had to work very close with the university, the whole committee was really approved by that. And the tuition increase was announced in tandem with the university. Some might observe that looks like the SMUSA is counterculture agency, that we're not protesting or fighting or anything. And so what do you guys think the vision or the language that we should use when they move to be disagreeing with the university? How should we have more independence?
Okay, so did everybody hear the question? It's how does SMUSA exercise its independence from the university when, and I think what you're trying to say is that when there's a divergence between your interests and the university's?
Yes.
Yes, okay, so does everyone have that question? I think that one's about 45 seconds. We'll go with Ossama first.
I believe as an independent organization, yes, we should always try our best to not to work with the university. to work with them, but to separate our asset from the university when it comes to kind of the voice of the students or when it comes to money, because whenever we get some money, if we got money from the university, that means we are not even in the building anymore, so we're working with the university. So that's why we have a sponsors committee, which is separate us from the university. We have other committees which make us separate from the university, and that's why we try our best, like, to work independently and have our voice independently, because at the end of the day, we are the voice of the student. So, yeah.
I think that that's a good question. I think that we have some influence in terms of what the university wants to do, but in terms of the tuition raising, we were informed on it. We wanted the student body to know. That's why we invited them to come to the student assembly. We could have argued it, we could have protested it, but at the end of the day, we wouldn't have as much negotiation power when it comes to reallocating that money back into bursaries and subsidizing the cost of tuition. I've seen historically in the past students protest tuition costs, and it's gone very badly with the administration. So it does cause more tension historically, but again, at the end of the day, we still want to have a backbone. We still want to have a strong voice at the end of, at the table, so we don't want to be completely passive. So I think it's finding a balance.
Thank you. I think it's really important for, in terms of welcoming, firstly, is that the university and SMUSA are equal partners. I don't think having a welcoming committee full of university administrators is necessarily, I understand the reason behind that, but you have to be equal partners. It's very important to do that. Secondly, in terms of tuition, the position taken, you know, by SMUSA, you know, really in my mind, you have to defend students and their interests, but you also have to, like Collette was mentioning, you have to pick your battles. Tuition was going to increase. The universities were given a very clear mandate from the province. I don't think necessarily protesting in all cases is necessarily the most effective solution. So you certainly have to make sure that you can take benefits out of what is a very unfortunate situation, which you know, no one wanted to see happen, but it did happen, and we tried to make the best. Or SMUSA has to try to make the best of some situations, but certainly advocate for student rights and student voice.
One reason I came to St. Mary's University was that at a low tuition fee, they provide a world-class education for all of us. And for that reason, we have a lot of out-of-province students and a lot of international students. So if there's a tuition raise and these students start for other options, because the other day I heard at the library, a student was thinking about transferring to another university. The St. Mary's administration needs to acknowledge this fact that if they keep it low, students have more, there will be more students coming into the university and getting a desired education if they want. It's all from a very personal level that I'm saying, but this is the fact, that's what I think.
I believe that SMUSA needs to keep a relationship with the university as a whole. Of course, it really depends on the situation overall. You kind of have to weigh all your options. It's definitely good to hear what the student voice has to say, but there's definitely those different things to consider, such as Collette said, reallocating those funds into bursaries and other programs that actually benefit the students. So yeah, it really depends on the situation.
And I think that we're at that point now where we
Okay, so I've been given the hook, which means, does anyone have a really passionate question that they absolutely have to answer and you can't decide? Okay.
Try to carry through those. I think it's really important.
I'll go with honesty, being ethical towards your responsibility, and lastly, transparency, because that's very important.
I would say my top three would definitely be student voice. So that communication, so kind of keeping that transparency, going back to saying what we're doing. And then finally, I would have to say after campus life. So, for example, work once you're done from school, what work options you have, having those employers possibly come and communicate with you.
Thanks, Lily, very much for the question. It's very, very important. I'm not sure anyone else knows. All I would have to say, my three are honesty, definitely. You guys, my friends, I'm kind of really honest. I don't know how good that is. Communication, I obviously have no lack of communication there. You guys can call me, text me, whatever. And like I said, only one class. I'm going to have lots of time to spend around campus. And I think thirdly, most importantly, dedication. Like I said, I really love SMU. I read board records. I lost. I know how to lose. Hard life, but I think that I can really give a lot to the parents and the
faculty. Question. I believe that diversity is a good one, because for the multicultural students we have in the university, friendly, we need a friendly president who is friendly with the students, make them love the student association. I will go with mental health awareness. And yes, this is a three for me.
Okay, so there were seven people who had their hands up who I didn't get to. You, someone in the middle. So three girls and four boys had their hands up and I didn't get to you. We are at the end. What I am going to suggest is that you come on down when we're done, and these guys will probably be willing to talk to you. Everyone here said they are open to communicating. And I think we're done. Thursday night, I think it's in the same location?
Yeah, same location, same time.
For the board of directors.